Welcome to the Free Truth Show on these changing times radio. I'm your host, Patrick Lynch, and we are live in Dorset on the south coast of England. Yesterday, Sunday, we were in Southsea giving out leaflets and flyers on chemtrails, and on the Saturday, March the 10th, we had Portsmouth Chemtrail Info Day, and we got out there. 12 people turned up with lots of flyers and banners, and we gave out about 1,000 flyers, about 1,000 flyers on Gunwharf Quays. It was amazing to meet everybody, absolutely amazing, lovely people. You sit here all the time, you know there's people out there all around the world that know about chemtrails, that are horrified and concerned and warning people. You speak to them on the phone, even if they're in Australia on Skype. You know they're horrified. You know they're concerned about this biggest crime in history, as I call it. What I say to people when I hand them the flyer, if they're walking past and they don't want to stop and talk, fair enough. I just let them know this is the biggest crime in the history of the planet, and it's not on the front page. So thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody who turned up and gave out information and was very enthusiastic and very supportive and helped out getting 1,000 flyers to the public. And just a big thank you and big hugs to everybody, really. And such kindness and such support is the reason we do what we do. So thank you. Makes it all worthwhile. We had a few problems from the video's up, actually. The video's up on YouTube. I finished it today. Part 4 I finished today. Part 4 has some audio missing from the YouTube video editor for some reason. But 1234 is up there now, the Chemtrail Information Day at Portsmouth. It's about half an hour's worth of footage, and there's various tete-a-tetes with the security. I didn't realise that apparently Gunwharf Quays is private property. So there was land site security and Shoal Enforcement Limited. And to be honest, they were quite pleasant. They weren't pushy or shovy, or they were very respectful, and so were we. And there was about 12 of us and lots of cameras, so most of the public were there to hear the cannon being fired across Portsmouth. To give you a brief idea what Portsmouth is, it's where the Pilgrim Fathers allegedly sailed from. In England, it's near Southampton. It's a big naval dockyard, a couple of battleships there. So lots of hard steel power being exhibited so you kind of get an idea what you're up against. Should the Army and the Navy turn on its own people, as requested by the New World Order. So everyone kind of cleared off, really, when the cannon was fired, kind of touristy thing. But we still had quite a few flyers to go, and I spoke to the manager there, Sean. He was very sweet with us, very respectful. I spoke to Heather in security, and she was also very sweet, very nice lady to us, and security in general were keeping a good eye on us, because although, as Sean the manager said, the centre manager, head of security, I think, although it's this is private property and this company owns it, You have a right to protest, he said. You have freedom of speech, but our policy is that we don't allow banners, and you must have our permission to give out leaflets. And I listened and respectfully conveyed that we were going to carry on anyway. And I did reach a bit of a compromise. I said, I won't banner. He said, no banners. I said, oh, okay, I won't banner. But didn't stop anybody else bannering, you see. So I said, look, as soon as we've got about 45 minutes to an hour to get rid of 1,000 flyers, generally it takes about that long, as quicker we get on with that, we're gone anyway. There's no point in being here. So we gave out as many as we could. And as the people cleared off, we went to the busy high street, pinned up the banner. Jane Long came along, was absolutely fantastic. She went and got some string. We were a bit short of string. We always forget the string. And we hang up the banner, end chemtrails, big red banner, end chemtrails. Part of it on the tree and part of it on the bin, I think it was. But it looked absolutely smart. And we gave out 1,000 flyers. We're stopping, walking around with the banner. There was two banners, Hailing Skywatch. Hailing Skywatch brought the banner too, and he set up in outside an abandoned shop, actually, just put it against the doorway there. Oh, sorry, the shop that was closed down. I joked that we could squat it and take it over and turn it into a KISS, Chemtrail Information Shop. You know, like they do at Christmas and then they clear off all the cheap stuff. And the security were riding around on sort of two-wheeled bikes, really. You know, the ones they stand in, they kind of wheel along like a Dalek, you know. That was quite amusing. They were keeping a close eye on us. And if anything, it was a distraction, really. We just wanted to get out of there, get the leaflets out to the public and tell people. So I stood there with a banner after the chat with the security and just shouted out to people that chemtrails are deadly, and a brief bit of sort of contrail explanation as opposed to chemtrail, and we're being poisoned by unmarked military jets, and sort of let rip, really, a bit. And then we went on to the high street, but it was right under the Spinnaker Tower, which is a big kind of sort of eye monument on its side that you go up in, £8.50 or something to go up the top. And to be honest, it's not that high. But it's apparently a private property complex, and we weren't aware of that, so it could have got ugly. They could have called the police and had us removed, etc., but they were very nice, I must say. And that's it, really. That's the way to do it. Have to be combative. You don't have to get in a mood with them, or you don't have to show your frustration at being tethered or attempting to tether you, your freedom of speech, etc. If you're respectful, then it can work miracles. So these security people, although they're often corrupt and criminal, it seems like these people were absolutely very nice people. So we were able to kind of work with them in a way. And it was a bit like that at the chemtrail rally at Cambridge. And we just got on with it. And in the high street, not one policeman walked along this area, this busy shopping area. It wasn't perhaps the high street, South Sea, but it was Palmerston Road, busy shopping area, all the usual brands, etc., in the shops. But not one policeman came and spoke to us and told us to take the banner down or anything. It was extraordinary. I met a chap from riding past on his bicycle. He didn't really want to stop, but I kind of ran alongside him and gave him a flyer, and he did stop. And he worked for, he claimed to work for GlaxoSmithKline. And he said, oh, no, Rockefeller doesn't have anything to do with it. I said, well, Rockefeller owns many of the pharmaceutical companies, many of them. Oh, no, Rockefeller has nothing to do with GlaxoSmithKline. Oh, and vaccines have helped lots of people, actually. Vaccines have helped a lot of people. Right. Okay. I should have asked him exactly what he did. Did he mix up the cauldron for the mix with aborted fetus tissue? On record, proven, found. mercury, it's on the insert. Was he in charge of a witch's brew? Probably a clerk or something. May not have even worked for them at all, but it was astonishing, really. And we had somebody calling us, marching up, some socialist guy that's been around for years in South Sea, Portsmouth, marching up and proclaiming that we were a bunch of lizard-loving lizard worshipping sort of lizard people, really, 8 foot kind of, all that kind of crap, you know. I said, oh well, that's funny that Rothschild said that when I asked him a few questions. He said the same thing. So it was a brilliant day. It really was a brilliant day. Great people came along, hailing Skywatch, Sam, D. Deansey on YouTube, all chemtrail video makers and commentators on the videos. Very good. Go and see them. Hailing Skywatch, Jane Long from Facebook. Hastings Against Chemtrails had their own info day. I've seen some of the videos so far, so good on you, Anne. And I'll just have a look at the chat box here. Excellent. I can't even move the cursor, so I can't see the chat box at the moment. I'm just waiting for my cursor to come back. Computer's been acting very strange today, so if you're listening, boys, give me a break. I'm guessing it's the gremlin side of there. So I would be able to chat to everybody in the chat box in thesechangingtimesradio.ning.com. And really, I'm quite buzzing from the atmosphere of Saturday. And it's looking like we may do one in Reading. I've yet to confirm yet with Reinhard von Holst on March the 17th, St. Patrick's Day, Reading. So that is a distinct possibility that that's going to happen. March the 17th in Reading. And let's hope Kat gets well soon. Kat, we wish you the best and hope you're feeling better soon. So before I sign off, thank you to everybody who turned up for the Chemtrail Information Day at Portsmouth. If you look on my YouTube channel, FreeTruth Show, FreeTruth Show on YouTube is the main video up there, part one. Look in the description, and 2, 3, and 4 will be there. I'm going to add number 4 there now. It's finally processed. And thank you for YouTube. Thank you to YouTube also. Hats off for creating a really crap new design, which is totally unuser-friendly. Thank you to everyone who turned out at Portsmouth Chemtrail Info Day. The video's there. You're all amazing people. Hello to Jane and Sam in the chat there. And thank you to Brightside, Binchek, and Duncan Starrett, and Jane Long, and Catwolf, and Light Blue, and Mark, and Peter, and Ravana 9000, and Robert Hugenboom, and that's a brilliant name, Sam Deans, and Solo Dog. Hi Solo, how you doing, ER? And Seamus, Tasha Ann, and Zeets, thanks for joining us in the chat, and thanks to everybody else who's listening on other variables. And it looks like the trolls are out in full force on my YouTube channel, and I've only got one thing to say, really. It's off the scale. Really is off the scale. Get a proper job. It's good night from me, Patrick Lynch, your host from the Free Truth Show. And remember, folks, there's only one way to beat these people. Fight the New World Order with every fibre of your being. Good night.